know, to see a patient who is struggling to even take a breath before surgery to a few weeks after you've been able to help them, have them walk out of hospital, having them look at you in the eyes and thanking you. And, you know, there's no gratification like that. I'm married and we have a 2.5-year son, and he's just a bundle of joy most days. And I just love spending time with him and having fun with him. I'm an avid photographer. I love photography. I love traveling and taking pictures around the world, and seeing things that, and experiencing on the beauty of nature and nature can bring. I was with one of the surgeons in Montreal, and we had seen a patient who was in his mid-60s. He had just retired, was looking forward to all this traveling and all that, and he had a heart attack. And so I remember talking to him and talking to his family, his wife, and they were just so disappointed at what has gone on in his life. And, you know, he had worked hard all his life, and this was going to be their dream. They had just bought a new vacation home in the Caribbean, but now he was worried that he would no longer be able to enjoy that lifestyle that he had worked hard his entire life for. So we ended up operating on him that night, and it was the most fascinating thing I've ever experienced at the time, up to that point in my medical training. And the following day, he did very well. We got his breathing tube out, and we got him out of bed on the second day, and he ultimately went home about a week later. And I remember seeing him about 4 weeks later when he came back, and he had felt like $1 million. And they had made all these travel plans now, and he was going to be able to finally enjoy that life that he had always wanted. And to see that difference that a surgeon can make in the life of an individual was just so fascinating, and that's what really persuaded me to do cardiac surgery.